You are all my children, created out of my love. In the womb of my love, you all have resided. From my heart, I have given you these blessings. The greatest possession you have is your mother.
The first point we must think that in Sahaja Yoga we do meditation, we do weekly meditation, we do havana, we do clearing practices like food soaking, candling, collective meditation, public programs. Which way puja is different? Why puja is required? Hope we have asked this question to ourselves. What is the so speciality of the puja? And whatever I am telling now about puja essence, not a single word from my side. It is just picked up from Sri Mataji, and I have put it in a order of understanding. What Sri Mataji has said, that puja is to develop, nourish our roots and attention. The roots are chakras and nadis. So this is to develop and nourish. Also, Srimati explained how it is. If you see in puja ceremony, is the only ceremony where we do not ask, where we do not demand any requirement to Sri Mataji. It is the first ceremony only to please Sri Mataji and deities. Deities inside Sri Mataji. So the whole puja function is like that, where we please our mother and deities inside her. Mother is more pleased, deities are more pleased, and we get more vibrations. And more vibrations, and that is how our roots get developed. And attention becomes settler and settler. And purer. Now, if you see the history part, as told by Sri Mataji, the puja is a process performed in ancient time in various countries, including India. It was done before Christ also. It was done by early Christians also. And our guru, who is Adi Shakti, the all deities, so many deities created by Adi Shakti while creating this universe, the deities always desire and seek the permission of Adi Shakti to perform puja to her. They are eager and ready, but they get only one chance in yuga. My understanding of yuga means 1,000 years. But whereas the Sahaja Yogis, we have got so many pujas every year. And when Sri Mataji used to have a tour in India, particularly the early period, 1975 to 90, Maharashtra tour. For 2 weeks, almost every alternate day there used to be puja. And Sri Mataji used to travel with all the Sahaja Yogis who have come from abroad. So all this is a pure love for her children. The Adi Shakti gave so many times chances and concessions. Concession in the form that we do so many mistakes. Sakshat, actually Adi Shakti is sitting there and we are performing puja. We don't know many things and Srimati kept on teaching. And still she forgives and gives further chances for puja. As you know, first 4 years there was no puja in Sahaj Yoga. When Srimati started in 1970, because of small number and the quality also of Sahaj Yogis. Because the reception of the vibrations coming from puja, from Srimataji, the recipient has to be of that quality and that quantity. That's why earlier Srimataji used to say, all Sahaj Yogis to come prepared for Sahaj Yoga. Clean yourself and you should be ready to absorb the vibrations. And that is the pure love for our children. No deities also get such chances. Now if you see the other technical side of this puja, there is a matter and material created around us, and that matter dominates our attention. Our attention becomes gross. So the puja is a process where the matter domination is overcome and the attention is made settler and settled. Because the matter attracts the attention. Essence of matter is attention. Matter is made of 5 elements, which represents our right side. And the right side ends up into ego. Ego ends up into violence, hatred, revenge. The more matter we collect, the more matter our attention is on the matter, that is where we ultimately land into. So we are to remove the domination of the matter on the attention. So we have to make the attention settler and settler, taking out from the gross. So attention can be made settler only when we take it on where there is a vibration, that is the spirit, Atma. So the puja gives 2 chances. One is we keep our attention not only on our spirit but on Adi Shakti. Best way is to keep attention on Srimataji, by which the attention becomes settler, because let the attention suck the vibrations, eat the vibrations, and drink the vibrations. So that is how the attention becomes that much settler. That is the chance in puja. At the same time, we are to detach from the matter. It is said that we should detach from matter by giving away the matter, by sharing the matter, and by aesthetically showing the matter. And we do all this in puja. We decorate aesthetically. We offer the matter in different forms to God, to Srimataji. And that is how the puja is getting a double benefit to us Sahaj Yogis, that we can make our attention settler by keeping attention on Srimataji and by giving various forms of matter, offering to Srimataji symbolically, because we cannot give her. She has created the whole universe. And out of that, a very small symbolical quantity we are offering to her. So that is like giving away the material. So you will find in puja, we offer to Srimataji from beginning to end of puja. And Srimataji, you know, doesn't accept anything as it is. Whatever we offer to her externally, we are offering the matter externally. Srimataji gives the reward internally. Whatever we offer, she immediately gives the reward to clean your different chakras, to enlighten your nadis. Also the matter is created by God. Only God can enjoy the matter. Human beings cannot enjoy the matter. Their attention will get diverted to the right side and end up into ego. So human beings cannot enjoy the matter, whereas the gods created the matter and they can enjoy. So we want to detach from matter and we want to offer the matter in a different form, different symbolically to the God. So both things are achieved. So by offering matter to the God, he, for us it is Srimataji Adi Shakti. She will not accept as it is. She will give in turn to us. So that is how the matter and the attention situation in puja. And this benefit is given only to Sahayogis. Only realized souls, realized people can worship Adi Shakti. Those who are not realized, they are not given chance to worship Adi Shakti. So you can imagine how many benefits we are getting by getting realization directly from Adi Shakti. Then she is giving as a realized soul to worship puja to her. Then our attention getting settler and enlightened by offering different matter, different material to her, we are getting internal reward. So all this explanation given by Srimataji, no incarnation, no God, no saint has given this information, this clarification of puja. First time, the Adi Shakti herself has explained into these details, what is matter, what is attention, and what exactly is a puja. But this puja has to be performed in a proper way, because Adi Shakti is sitting there. She has given you chance to perform puja. We cannot do any way we like. It has to be done with complete humility and Shraddha. And we have to follow that respect inside heart while performing puja. And a particular process which is called science of spirituality. We cannot, just because we can offer anything, so offer any way we like. No. Srimataji has called it science of spirituality. So this science has to be understood. Which way we can offer, how to offer, what is the sequence of offering, and after each offering, what exactly we should do. And while doing all this, there has to be humility and Shraddha. And this science of spirituality is followed to get the best results. Now, best results is nothing but pleasing Srimataji. Srimataji is pleased more. We get more vibration. The deities inside Srimataji are pleased. We get more vibrations. So that is the best result. But if we do not follow the science of spirituality, then we will not get that best result. It is just like we go for an exam. Always the attempt is to achieve highest marks. And we attempt. Similarly, we should know and understand what is the science of spirituality with complete humility, not show off, not superficially, not hypocritically. It has to be from inside, from the heart. And that is how we get the best results. At the same time, we have to have proper recipient also. The Sahajogi sitting in front of Sri Mataji, they have to be of that quality and quantity. So the more, because the larger the collectivity, the larger the depth of prayer, and they can absorb more and more vibrations. But they have to be of that quality. Also, Sri Mataji said, essence of Sahaja Yoga is a protocol. Now, we cannot list down protocol like we do in various government offices and companies, private companies. These are protocols. No, here the protocols come automatically by humility, by Shraddha, that is faith, and sincerity. The moment these are there inside us and we are performing puja with complete humble heart and inside heart complete thankfulness, the protocol comes automatically. We can write down if required, but the humility, Shraddha, sincerity, humble heart, thankfulness has to be there. And the more we perform with a humble heart and thankfulness, Sri Mataji and of course deities inside Sri Mataji are pleased. And that is what is the main aim of the puja. Now we can look at it in a different form. As you know, in Sahaja Yoga, recognition of Sri Mataji is very, very important. You have to recognize Sri Mataji in the full form as Adi Shakti, not as one of the guru, one of the gods, so many gurus moving around. Sri Mataji is Adi Shakti. So we have to recognize her in that scale, which is the infinity scale. This is another part of the puja. You know, the puja has different facets. Now this here, the requirement, the essence of Sahaja Yoga, which is the recognition. What we are doing, we are praying Sri Mataji in puja. When puja starts, beginning to end, we are doing prayers. We are doing stuti, praises. We are praising Sri Mataji, her powers, her compassion, and so on. We are doing stuti. So by doing this, also while doing prartha, stuti and prayer, praise and prayers, we are offering. So that offering is by action, and prayers and praise in words. So action and words put together, we are doing a deep expression of affirmation of recognition. So automatically the recognition, affirmation takes place by a deep expression. So that is also part of the puja. Wow. What exactly to pray? What should be the praise? In what heart it should be, the prayer should be. That is how also is explained the effect of puja. And puja is considered as a epitome, highest सेरेमनी और फंक्शन इन सर्ज होगा। इट इज एन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड इवेंट बिकॉज वी हैव टू फर्स्ट टेक परमिशन ऑफ श्री माता जी टू परफॉर्म पूजा, वी हैव टू इन्वाइट श्री माता जी एंड वेलकम श्री माता जी, परफॉर्म पूजा एंड द लास्ट पार्ट इज आरती एंड ऑफरिंग प्रसाद। सो दीज आर द नाउ नाउ लेट अस सी we'll show you now what do we offer to Shri Mataji in puja, because every atom we offer to Shri Mataji, she doesn't accept as it is. Immediately a reward is given which is internally, which cannot see, but we can feel inside us, inside our being. Like we offer flowers, the moment we offer flowers, Shri Mataji immediately clears our Mooladhara and Swadhisthana, because flowers have fragrance, flowers have very colorful and beautiful, so that fragrance is the essence of Mother Earth, and Mother Earth is a part of our Mooladhara. So that is how the moment such flower we give, the Mooladhara is cleared by Shri Mataji. The moment we offer beautiful flowers, which is aesthetically decorated flowers, and aesthetics and the beauty is the part of the Swadhisthana, Shri Mataji clears our Swadhisthana. We offer, I will take name of few items, water, we offer on her lotus feet, Shri Mataji clears our nabi and void. We offer rice, Shri Mataji clears our nabi. Now offering water at the lotus feet, Shri Mataji's lotus feet symbolize Ganesh principle, Ganesh Tattva. So it is a great inner respect to offer water at her lotus feet. So here automatically the Ganesh Tattva, and because water is offered, so our nabhi void also gets cleared. Now this is called Panchamrut, where the five elements are offered to Shri Mataji. Here Shri Mataji is accepting on her hands. We do this at the lotus feet also. This is called Charanamrit. The five elements are offered here: milk, curd, honey, ghee. So all the five elements are offered. Shri Mataji will internally reward us to clear our chakras, to give more and more vibrations. Next, because each material has its own importance and the essence. All the decorating items are also offered to Shri Mataji. Let this slide going on. Then we offer, after the jewelry, we offer the sari. Now this is the puja where Sri Mataji take the sari on her shoulders, the new sari offered. But here Sri Mataji has wrapped up the whole sari just to please the sahyogis. And to offer directly on her shoulders or to wrap up, we could have kept sari in a folded shape as it is. There is a method that to indicate that Sri Mataji, this sari is for you only. Well, once she opens and accepts on her shoulder, it means Sri Mataji has taken it. After that, it is up to Sri Mataji how to use and where to use that sari. So, if we offer new as it is in a new folded form, we may think whether Sri Mataji will open it, use it or not herself. So, Sri Mataji is showing it to us that yes, I have accepted it for myself and I am using it. Can we go to the next slide? Now, this is called Oti. Now, whatever you are seeing in this video is the actual Oti which used to be offered in this form. You see, every atom is being put. Fruit, rice, coconut, into a cloth in the lap of Sri Mataji. This is also Oti is such an atom. Now, it is a system where to ensure that this is to you only, to yourself only. So, to symbolically to show that normally a part of the sari, which is called pallu, that is opened. And it is put into that part of the sari so that it is fully 100% owned by Sri Mataji or by that God to whom you are offering. So the Oti, the atoms are so many that a pallu may not be sufficient. So sometimes the cloth of Sri Mataji is kept in her lap, and in that we offer all this symbolically to show and tell that this is to you only and only to you. So that is OT. Now can we see the next slide? Can you hold? Oh, hold this. Now this is after having offered all right from all the material, the sequence of puja goes from the lotus feet of Sri Mataji and upward towards the crown. And that is the sequence it is offered, the material. Every atom, it may be very simple atom, it may be very costly atom, that is to us. For God, everything is same. Whether it is a gold or whether it is a Mother Earth, God will not differentiate. It is only the human beings we differentiate. But while offering, the sequence is we start from the lotus feet, go towards the crown. And after the crown, symbolically, to show that it is now a completion, we perform the aarti. Aarti is to show the light. And also by which Sri Mataji will open our ajnas. All the participants, all the sahyogis who are sitting there, so their ajna will be cleared by Sri Mataji by the light. So you can play this video. Now, Sri Mataji is pleased to, you know, by one hand, which is called Abhay, means she's giving the shelter. And by the other hand, it is called Dan, means she is offering, giving us so much material, so much everything by the left hand. And Ashray means protection, Ashray. Protection by the right hand. It is called Abhay, and the left hand is called Dan, Abhay Dan. So Sri Mataji is giving to her bhaktas, to all the sahyogis. At the end of the puja, symbolically. We can go to the next slide. Now here, as a part of puja, we are giving, this is called bhog or navedya, which is directly offered to Sri Mataji and for Sri Mataji to eat. And there is another part which is called prasad. The prasad is offered during aarti. To Sri Mataji. Mataji will just touch by hand, and that prasad is to be distributed and consumed by the participant sahyogis or all the sahyogis, wherever they are. And this navedya is offered to Sri Mataji herself. The leftover, if any, it can be taken by sahyogis as a vibrated prasad. So this is also part of the puja. This navid can be offered after the aarti or before the aarti. If it is a nirakar puja, we offer before the aarti. If it is sakar, means it is to be given to Sri Mataji, so we used to offer it after aarti. Can we go to the next slide? This slide shows different sahyogis or the country group who have come to give gifts to Sri Mataji. Now again, Sri Mataji will not accept the gift as it is. For every material you give Sri Mataji inward, it will reward. So this chance is given to sahyogis, and this is not only to take or get the material, but chances are given to Sahyogis to offer material, to get reward and make your attention more settler and enlightened. Whereas Adishakti doesn't need anything. So this is Sri Mataji coming, welcoming, or Sri Mataji if she's living somewhere, so we can also do this small lotus feet puja. This is again symbolically, and it is for every action, every activity, every material we use in puja, it is a chance for us to get inward reward for every atom and every action. Because God doesn't need this, but it is given a chance to Sahyogis, to the children, to Bhaktas, to clear their chakras and nourish, develop their roots and attention. Thank you very much. Can we close?